In this video, we are going to review BenQ w1070 projector. You can see the projector here. This is a full size projector that offers you 1080 pixel of image output. It is a full HD projector that offers you very sharp contrast ratio and vibrant color. Along with this, it also supports NVIDIA 3D technology, where you can simply play 3D videos on it. It is a minimum configuration projector that works fine with all kind of videos, especially with HD videos, and offers you 3D output. BenQ w1070 is a DLP projector. You can see the prime features on the top side. It offers you HDMI connectivity with NVIDIA 3D Vision Ready technology, where you can simply play 3D videos on it. The projector also comes with NVIDIA 3D glasses. These are the glasses, 3D glasses that comes with this projector, which you can use to play 3D videos. While it also offers you a vertical lens shift feature on the top, on the body itself. This is the control button where you can simply turn it on and off. You can enter the menu, you can customize the screen which you are getting on the projector screen or on the wall, wherever you're using it. You can select the source from this button. You can press the eco blank button when you are not using the projector. It will not turn it off, but it will turn off the lens. Also, this is the center button used to choose from various mode, like from movie mode or dynamic mode, etc. Now the projector is having quite a decent design. It has a glossy finish on the top side. At the front you have the lens. This is the lens, along with the ventilation chamber. There is a small stand also available at the bottom, which you can use to lift it up. There is an IR receiver on the front side. On the right lies a single speaker. These are the integrated speaker that you can use to listen to music or audio when you are not having any separate speaker available. But to get better quality, it is recommended that you go for better speakers. At the back side, you can see all the connectivity options here. There are two HDMI ports available. There are component cable port available, where you can connect a set-top box or you can connect other video devices. There's a VGA cable, a VGA port also available, where you can connect a PC directly. And there is a separate panel available for the audio, for the audio devices. You can see there's an audio out and audio in jack. In terms of design, BenQ w1070 is decent. It does not look too made up from a cheap plastic kind of material. It has a glossy finish and it is also a bit heavy. At the top side, you can see lies a lens zoom lever, and this is the lens shift button. Now you can place it on a table, or you can simply place it vertically on the upside. There's a mounting panel available at the bottom side. You can see these are the holes available, which you can use for ceiling mount. BenQ w1070 is great for watching HD movies. It offers you a 10,000:2 contrast ratio with 2000 lumen brightness, and of course 3D support. Now there are certain limitations while using a 3D video, while watching a 3D video on this. First, if you're using this on a PC, you will need a graphic card that supports NVIDIA 3D, while or else there will be no proper output on the screen. And second, if you're using set-top box on this, you will also need a 3D support on that. The internal menu of this projector offers you a 3D option, which you have to enable and disable, but that option is disabled if whatever system you're using is not having 3D. The specification of this projector is, it is a DLP projector that offers you a full 1080 pixel of native resolution. The maximum resolution that you will get on this projector is 1920x1080. Which is quite great. The brightness is 2000 ANSI lumen, while the contrast ratio is 10,000:1. It offers you 1.07 billion color output, which is quite great. Diagonally, the image size can be expected up to 40 inches to 35 inches, which is quite great. The lamp of this projector consume around 240 watt, which is quite high. It is a power in terms of power usage, the projector simply is high on power usage. But it offers you a complete cinema type of features. It gives you different connectivity option, and different set of picture mode are also available in this, which are dynamic, standard, cinema, 3D, etc. We'll just connect the projector to a PC and we'll see the output. And now you can see here, I have connected the projector. I have connected it on a PC through a VGA cable, and on which I am getting a nice resolution. The maximum resolution which I am getting here right now is around 1920x1080 pixel, which is quite great. For proper connectivity, you can use these two HDMI port also, where you can get much better video output. Right now on the VGA cable, it is giving me a standard quality. And for audio, you can see I have showed you before, there are two audio in and audio out jack available, among which you have to connect one 3.5mm audio cable on the audio in port, which is the blue jack, and the other part of the cable to the audio out jack of your PC, which is the green port. So in this way, you can see you can hear the audio from the projector. You have to simply adjust the audio jack properly. The screen resolution usually depend on your video memory, the graphic card, etc., whatever you're using. Right now you can see the maximum resolution I'm getting on my PC is 1920x1080, which is quite great. Now here you can see a sample image on the screen. You can see it has covered up the entire wall. Now this sample screen is quite vibrant. It has a proper color output. Now the quality is low due to VGA output. If I have connected this on the HDMI port through a high-end graphic card, the resolution must be much more better. Now I'll play a sample video also, and we'll later on move ahead with other features of this projector. Now this is the sample video along with audio which is coming from the projector. Now this is the sample video, and along with the audio that you can listen is coming from the speaker of this projector, which is placed on the left side. Now on the screen, you can see a sample web page layout of techarena.in. You can see the output of this projector. Now this is a nice 5 feet screen. You can see the output is still quite great. There is no blurry issue here. It is working really fine. In terms of resolution, BenQ w1070 is really awesome. It is designed for home entertainment, where you can have great HD video output and also 3D support, but there are some limitations. As I said before, for 3D you require a device that support 3D. The projector comes with 3D ready support, so you just have to enable the settings. Now you can also customize the resolution as per your need. Now you can see the screen that right now I am having on my wall, it is really large. To reduce the resolution, you have to go in screen resolution and you have to set it at a lower level. You can see the screen size is reduced. In the same way, you can make it more smaller. Now this one is around 1280x720 pixel. You can see the screen size is quite reduced. In the same way, the maximum I am getting is 1920x1080, which is the biggest screen resolution here, which covers the entire wall. So in this way, you can customize the screen resolution, you can reduce and increase the size also. Now we will check out the OSD menu and whatever controls which are available on the projector. Here on the body, you can see there are few setup buttons available through which you can control the projector. This first one is the power button. Now this one is the menu key. When you press it, the OSD menu loads up. Now this menu looks similar to menu that we see in a regular monitor, in a PC monitor. After pressing the menu button, this is the first screen you're going to see. The menu is divided into some set of different categories, among which we are in the picture mode, and you can see the arrow keys. You can use the arrow keys to navigate from left to right. Now here under picture mode, you can see there are different set of preset mode available, which you can press and you can simply get that kind of look on the screen. Now this is the standard. You can see there is a changes in the color. Now this one is a cinema mode. This is the user one, which is the custom mode, again a user mode, and this is the dynamic, which we are using by default. Below you can see you can manually adjust the brightness and contrast. You can simply modify the sharpness. You can set the color temperature here. Right now it is normal. When you set it on cool, the color temperature changes a bit. This is lamp native. This is warm color. At below you can see the lamp power. Now you can simply adjust the power used by lamp. Right now it is on the normal mode. You can simply set it on economic, or you can set it on smart eco, which is more beneficial to save the power used by projector. There's an advanced mode also available at the bottom that map allow you to control the clarity of this projector. Now it is, you can see the noise reduction is set on 16. You can keep it on maximum to get the maximum clarity. You have to press the menu button back to go outside. In the same way, you can see there is a color temperature, gamma selection, brilliant color feature and color management option. Under color management, you can simply modify the color setting of this projector. You can configure red, blue, cyan, magenta, yellow colors here, and you can modify hue, gain and saturation. So these are the manual settings under advanced mode, or you can simply press the reset picture settings to bring it back on the default option. Now the second category here is dedicated for the audio. You can simply adjust the volume. You can see the volume bar here. You have to press the arrow key to increase and decrease it. The third section is display, where you can simply configure the aspect ratio. You can modify the keystone, screen position, overscan adjustment, digital zoom, etc. And below you can see film mode, 3D combo filter and 3D, which are grayed out, which are turned off because my system does not have a 3D support. So I'm not going to get this output on my screen. Now we'll check out the different aspect ratio available here. There are some set of preset mode available. Right now we are on real. I'll keep on modifying them one by one, where you can, and you can see the output on the screen. This is 4:3 screen aspect ratio. This is wide angle. This is anamorphic, letterbox, and this one is on auto. Again back on the real mode. So you can simply configure different aspect ratio from the menu itself. And as I said, for 3D you required a system that has a 3D output support, which is most commonly found in graphic card. The fourth one is the system setup, where you can modify the language, you can configure sleep timer, menu settings and etc. This is the advanced setting which I have showed you before, where you can simply modify the lamp setting, you can configure the HDMI output here. You can, if you're not able to understand what type of screen you're, if you're not able to adjust the screen, there's an option available called as test pattern. You just have to turn it on and you will get a grid based layout on the screen. You can see this is the grid, where you can simply customize the projector's image output. Now this is helpful for those who want to adjust the, who want to fit the screen inside a projector screen. To turn it off, you just have to go back in the menu, you have to go in advance and turn off the test pattern. So this was the OSD menu of projector, BenQ projector W1070. The last section is the information section, which give you the current in detail about the output you are getting on the screen, like the use preset mode, resolution, the color system, etc., the 3D format. In terms of usage, BenQ W1070 is very easy to use and configure. It is a plug and play projector. You do not require to mess with any complicated settings here. But configuring 3D on this is a bit problematic, because I have tried it on a system also, on a laptop which has a AMD graphic card, latest graphic card. The 3D was not working. So there are some set of settings which are required to configure, and I think and I have also tried the manual. So in terms of 3D output, I find the projector a bit complicated, but at least it is having the feature compared to other projector which does not offer you 3D output. Now we will move ahead with a small multimedia test of this projector. I'm going to play a 1080 pixel video on this, and we'll see the output here along with audio. So you can see the video output here. The maximum resolution that I am getting is quite vibrant on VGA also. So you can simply imagine if I have connected this on HDMI output, the video output must be much more better. I'll play the same video in a smaller resolution and we'll see. Now this is the smaller resolution and we're going to play the video. You can see still the quality is quite great here. So in this way you can simply configure different set of video output on this device and you can play your favorite movies. There is no problem with configuration, there is no problem with setup here. Only thing I have said that it is complicated to configure 3D on this because it entirely depends upon the device you are using. Same thing is also applicable for images here. You can simply connect your video camera or you can connect your DSLR on this projector directly through HDMI cable and you can simply play your high quality images on a wide screen. You can see the zooming, maximum zoom quality, still there is no blurry issue here. Everything is crisp and clear. So in this way BenQ w1070 is a really effective projector and it is an ideal solution for home entertainment. BenQ w1070 is great for home entertainment. It offers you good features and it is comfortable for usage. It is loaded with many new things that offers you great output in terms of home entertainment. It is a plug and play kind of device which is very easy to configure and use. In terms of design, it is a bit bulky but offers you all kind of control over the body itself. You can also use a remote for that. It is a great choice for multimedia output. Videos are more clear if you place it well and if you try to watch it from a distance. It is necessary that there should be a proper gap between the screen and projector, which is one of the major issue here. You have to adjust it properly. You can keep it on a table also. You can simply hook it on the ceiling through a mounting panel. Everything, the image output usually depend on the kind of placement you're doing it. Now in terms of setting, it is very easy to configure. I have showed you the menu before. It is simple to use. While in terms of audio output, the internal speakers are not so great. For getting a surround sound kind of output in the movie quality, you must hook a 2.1 or 5.1 speaker on it, or simply connecting a home theater system will be more better. The cost of this projector is around ₹1 lakh, which is really high, but in terms of features, if you're looking for an home entertainment solution, this projector is an ideal solution. Now there are more affordable projectors available in the market compared to this one, but they are LCD or CRT projectors which are not great in terms of resolution. Due to DLP projection system, it gives you a very detailed and crisp image quality. The positive aspect of this projector is it is a plug and play device. It offers you great video output and there are multiple connectivity options available, while the negative aspect of this projector is it is poor on audio, it is overpriced, and heating is one of the most major issue. After using it for an hour or for 2 hours, the projector gets really heat up. You have to turn it off for some time. That's all for now. For more review, tutorial, news, and updates on latest technology, visit techrena.in. Thank you. Have a nice day.